Amy Adams.
Yeah.
Well, here we are, Kew Gardens indeed. Not the actual gardens, but a station. You can get there through there, but I'd rather look around here briefly. Nice cafes, nice little place to have a cup of tea. We'll get to the gardens in a minute. This little rail at the side at the bottom is for bicycles to help them up and down the steps. I'm not sure how easy it is because wouldn't the handlebars hit the wall, but anyway, I've not seen anyone use them, so I don't know how they work. I suppose if you tilt the bike it would be alright. Kew Gardens is quite near Heathrow Airport, so we will be hearing a lot of low-flying planes coming into land. It's a bit breezy today, as you can probably hear. 11% chance of rain, but otherwise sunny intervals. So lots of nice fluffy white clouds. Basically, to get to Kew Gardens, you just walk straight up from the station, all the way up here. And there's the entrance across the road, or one of the entrances. It's a big place. We won't get to see even half of it, most likely, but we'll see a lot. And I suppose if you want more, you can let me know. One reason I haven't been here before is you have to pay to go in. When I first moved to London, it was one penny to go in, which just gave them the right, basically, to throw you out. Is this the entrance? No, this is the exit. Hi. Bit of a puzzle to get in here. You have to pass an IQ test to get into this place. Can you solve the maze? Hi, one please.
Are you over 65?
No.
That's 21.45 with donation or 19.50. 19.50 without donation.
Okay, then 21. London. Thank you. Not quite sure why they want to know where I'm from. I suppose it's stats. Managements are obsessed with stats these days. Don't know what I'm going to do with the map either. I'll stick it in my pocket. I could try reading it, I suppose, but let's just wander around. I know roughly where some of the things are. So here's a map that we can all look at. And we're in the middle at the bottom there, the blue entrance. So we're probably going to concentrate mostly on the bottom right corner of this park or gardens today. Or in part one, because I think it's more than an hour's worth in here. You can easily spend half a day at least in here if you like a leisurely walk around some nice gardens. If you're bored easily, well, go to Disneyland or something. You stand in a queue for 5 hours. Kew Gardens is more than 250 years old, so a lot of these trees were planted early on, and so they're quite old now. That ahead is the palm house. We'll be going there in a bit. That big conservatory, but I kind of fancy looking at the lake and whatnot first. Canada goose. These two stone dragons are genuine Ming Dynasty stone dragons. I'll point at the sign, you can sort of read it at your leisure if you want to freeze the video. We have a duck and duckling there. Gigantic leaves. This is known as the Botanical Brasserie. It's a bit pricey, of course. Everything in Kew Gardens is pricey, including getting in, if you ask me, but anyway. Here's the menu. Let's have a quick look. Fine.
the buggy?
Just going to nip up to the Temple of Aeolus. The sign also points out that all the little hills and whatnot at Kew have been created because the area was actually flat when it was first founded. Down there is the Agaeus or Aegis Evolution Garden and the kitchen garden bit. The Princess of Wales Conservatory is in the background. We may get to that later. I think having gone round the little lake there, it is time to go to the palm house. It's very hot and humid in here, and my glasses have steamed up, but the camera seems okay. I think because it's a bit hot, the camera is hot. So let's just wander around and see what we see. You can freeze on any of the signs if you want to read them.
So hot in here.
Did he say why is it so hot in here? When he has figured that out, I guess he will have achieved enlightenment.
Thank you.
Close the door? I have a feeling not. No, indeed. Too much to concentrate on. Let's go and have a look at this place. This bit is labelled as a rose garden, and the little conservatory up ahead is for water lilies.
Of the actual watering, I mean, it's a pretty mature display now, so it does use up quite a lot.
Yeah.
The Nepenthes baskets can be soaked through, but you don't. I would just spray over the pile and just get that, to be honest. The ponds in the entrance will need filling.
It's
just topping up.
Ready?
And if you do use the side irrigation, that doesn't come into these
beds. Yeah, okay.
That's been cut off this year.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, it's a bit more peaceful out here. Oh, let's head somewhere else, shall we? The dodgy artwork up there is called the Hive. So it's kind of like being in a beehive, it's meant to be. It's a permanent display, I think. And this, we're just getting on to the boardwalk. Or the broadwalk. What is it? Broad, yes. Leads us down to the Orangery, which is that white building.
Oh,
the Orangery is basically a cafeteria. At least that's what it's used for these days. Drinking fountain actually works, there you go. Some baby mallards, I think. And that's a baby coot with one of its parents behind the plant. I saw a dragonfly there. Of koi carp. You probably can't see them, but there are loads of little fish hidden by the reflections there. could be closed. It doesn't look quite normal, does it? I think there's building work going on in here. Yeah. Time to go. I think that's the herbarium and library. It's set up to be a lecture hall, I think, or actually it may be the Nash Conservatory, but it looked like it was being set up as a lecture hall. Some wood chipping going on there. This is ginkgo biloba, maidenhair tree. See, the leaves have two lobes. very ancient species. Strange that these three species are close to extinction. I've seen the ginkgo biloba elsewhere, and this, the monkey puzzle tree. But it's getting a bit rare in its native Argentina and Chile, I think. I can remember that big tree up ahead from about 40 years ago when I first moved to London. It's still here. Let's go up into this secluded garden and enjoy the peace and quiet and the wood chipping noises. I think this will be a good place soon to end the video and part one, and I'll carry on in a part two, which I'll release a week later, assuming I can get all the processing done and whatnot. A nice throne for me to sit on while I say goodbye. I'll see you in next week's video in part two. Bye for now.